Today we're going to build and paint some Warhammer Age of Sigmar Death Rattle skeletons. The instructions are numbered and have pictures for easy to follow, and the skeletons look like these once they are built. You can, of course, build them without the shields on, as you may find this easier to paint. I have done this with some of mine, and with others I have put the shields on and painted them with shields, and they do kind of get in the way a little bit. All of the skeletons are getting a brush on primer with Reaper Black Primer. The skeleton goes into the painting handle because this gives you more control. You don't have to touch the miniature, and I'm using my trusty Humbrol Coloro number 4. The bigger the brush, the better for doing base coats such as primer, so you don't get as many streaks. So you can use a bigger brush than this, that is perfectly fine. These are the paints that I'm going to use to paint these skeletons. If you wish to follow along, use these paints or something similar. I'm going to start with a nice thin layer of Ushanti Burn on all of the exposed bone area. Remember to not have your paint too thick and add a little bit of water to thin it down if necessary so that you don't obscure any of the detail of the miniature. Don't worry if you get paint where you don't want it. This is a nice light colour and you'll easily be able to go over with the correct colour later on. Again, I'm using a Humbrol Coloro brush, but a smaller one this time, with a nice tip and a big belly. Do not get your paint near the ferrule, a bit of metal at the bottom. If you get paint all the way down there, it will dry and it'll make your bristles splay out, and that's no good at all for painting miniatures. Once you're happy that you've got all the bone colour painted, then we can move on to the next colour. I'm using Corn Red from Citadel for the cloth areas on the skeletons. I really like this red. It's nice and flat and matte and not glossy, and I really do like the effect that it gives on the miniatures. Again, add it to your palette and add a little water to it just to make it a little bit thinner and flow better on your miniature. Cover all of the cloth areas on the skeleton, including underneath and inside in between his legs. Once we've done all the red cloth, we're going to move on to the brown strap, and I'm going to use Vallejo's Flat Earth. This is a really nice, normal brown colour. If you've ever watched any of our Twitch streams, you will hear me constantly complaining about brown. Flat Earth is a nice brown colour, and I do like using this one when I have to use brown. I'm also using a very watered-down version of this. Lots of water on the palette for inside of the shield to give it a nice, rusty, browny, still wood-looking feel, but not just a stark, solid brown. After we've painted all of the brown sections, we move on to the silver. Now, this is an air paint, but you can use it. It just means that it's thinner than the normal silver paint. And I have mixed it with a small bit of pure black from Reaper just to make it slightly darker. I'm also going to use that pure black mixed to make shading underneath where his chin would be and under around his arms and things like that to give a bit of shadow to the metal. I'm using this colour combination on all the metal parts of the skeleton, including his sword and his helmet and his breastplate and on the inside of his shield. Using this combination, adding a little bit more black for some shading and a little bit more silver for some highlights, but just these two colours. I'm also using the silver to pick out the detail on the shield and around the outside, and later I will add blue as a contrast colour for the shields. Once all the colours are dry, I used Sapio Wash from Reaper all over the miniature to give the armour and the cloth and the bone itself a dirty, washed out colour. Don't want it bright and shiny because this guy's been roaming around, being undead for absolutely ages, fighting, and he's definitely not got nice, shiny armour. And this is a really good way to get a nice, dull and dirty look to your armour, and also highlights the lovely features of the bone and takes off that stark white, giving everything a dulled down look while still maintaining the colours that you've put on. Next, I'm going to use Winter Blue from Reaper. It's a nice soft blue colour to contrast the shiny silver of his shield and give it a different look to the red of his cloth. I mixed in a little bit of black with the blue to give some shading, and I also used the blue neat again over the top to give a little bit more highlights, again so that the whole thing doesn't look so bright, because I do think that this guy's been roaming around fighting for ages. His shield's all beat up, his cloth's beat up, his sword's all beat up. He's not going to have nice shiny things that he's carrying around with him. Next, we're going to get the flat earth back out from Vallejo, and we're going to use that to dirty up the bottom of the cloth and add some more shading, add some more grime, really make this guy look like he's been through the wars while he's been fighting. And then we're going to go over the top with the red again, just to pick out more highlights, and continue this until you're happy with the way that it looks. Continue using a slight bit of black and the brown and the red, just to give shading and highlights where you think that they should be. Then use the silver and the point of the brush again to make some lines as if they are scratches in his armour. Then I use the bone colour again to pick out the highest points of his bone on his face, on his fingers, to highlight up those bones back again from putting that wash on. I then used flat earth and the side of my brush on the most raised parts of the cloth to give it some texture with little lines going down, just to add some extra detail to that cloth. Then we're going to do the basin. This Kraut Cover basin is super awesome and I really like it. And we're also going to use the Geek Gaming basin glue. We sell all of these things at mightylancergames.co.uk, including the Death Rattle Skeletons. Now, I never can get the glue out properly. Or I ever get too much or too little. So I find it easier just to take the lid off and dip my old paintbrush, use an old paintbrush for this. I use a paintbrush that I always use for glue. Don't use your new paintbrushes, you'll ruin them. I use it and I dip it into the lid so that I can get the glue out that I need. Put it all over the base of the miniature, everywhere that you want the basing material to stick. Avoid around the sides because we want to keep them clean, but anywhere that you want this basing material to stick to, just paint on this glue and then we dip the miniature into the basing material. The basing material will stick to the glue that you've just put on and give you a nice good coverage. Leave it to dry. If you're worried about the basing material coming off, you can add some sealant on top. We sell that from Geek Gaming Scenics as well. You can add some sealant on top with a pipette. Lightly tap off any excess basing material and then you can paint around the outside with black or a different glue if you prefer, and then your skeletons are all ready for your gaming table. I hope you like this video. Please leave me a comment, a like, and even a subscribe would be absolutely wonderful. Remember to get all your Warhammer and hobby needs from mightylancergames.co.uk and our shop in Bridlington. Thank you very much and take care.